Hey YouTube, I got a little video here to show ya. So we have my old aging 2008 Mac Pro, and let's see here, I kind of pushed the 2.8 gigahertz Xeon to almost 3.2 gigahertz, just a little shy. I could actually go higher than this. But let's talk about how you overclock this and why there are some caveats. Because these caveats are going to be very, very important. All right. First things first. This can be easily overclocked using setFSB. Now, if you open up setFSB, now, first of all, let's just take a look. My clocks are right now stock. 400 megahertz, and if that's times 7, that would be 2800 megahertz. First thing you want to know is what kind of clock is in your 2008 Mac Pro, or clock generator. The one that's actually in these machines is the ICS932S401EGLF. So if I hit get front side bus, we can get some results here. The highest you can really push this to is 454. If your memory and CPU permit, that is. Mine allows me to. In fact, it lets me go beyond. But what happens if you go beyond? You can't reboot the computer. The EFI firmware that is in the Macintosh computers simply do not like that. So a bus speed of 454 is your absolute max. Now, I'm hand-holding this and not screen recording because we're going to do this live. So actually, I have a batch file here, which will execute this command with no waits, give it the speed here, and the clock and everything, the clock generator, and using the ultra mode, because you do need the ultra mode enabled, otherwise you're not going to get these speeds, and then do a restart. Now, why am I restarting this computer, though, after I do this? Well, these Mac Pros, for whatever reason, have an interesting quirk. They don't use a real-time clock chip, apparently. Or they do, but something weird's going on. It counts time just like how the IBM PC XT did, using the bus clock as a reference, basically. So if you overclock it, that clock starts going tick, 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 tick. It's like, whoa, wait a minute, buddy. In like a day, you'll gain like 20 minutes. It's ridiculous. But when you reboot it, it self-calibrates. But remember, the 454 clock is the highest we can go. So I made a little batch file script that I can click right from here. I just tell it, yes, we're going to do that. It's going to set it to 454. Setting completed. Then it will close out. Now it's going to reboot. You are about to be signed out. Windows will shut down in less than a minute, which is fine. We want it to reboot. Because remember, if you look at the clock, it's really kind of hard to see, but that's really not seconds. Well, actually it is. I already rebooted the machine in 454. I forgot. So the clock you would actually see in before the overclock was actually slower than seconds because I actually downclocked it back to the stock speed before making this video. Just so I could show you this process. So now it's going to do a reboot. In the higher front side, or the higher bus speed clock. Perfect. Now, of course, when you upgrade these, overclock these machines, please do the overclock one at a time. You know, don't just jump to the highest just because I can, and then think, oh, the machine should be stable. It probably won't be. In fact, these machines do have a way of telling you if a memory module is getting too many errors and stuff like that. So my memory bay is not lighting up any modules, which means the overclock has not caused any issues with my memory. Because remember, this machine has ECC memory, so it's actually pretty good. We're still waiting for the hard. There we go. Now we're going to let it boot up. Now remember, the overclock, it just does the reboot for you automatically. That's perfectly fine, and that's what we want. We want to be able to reboot the machine by a script, because if you set the overclock and you forget to reboot, next thing you know, you're going to have a little bit of a problem because your time is just slipping away. So, machine's still rebooting. That's perfectly fine. It's just going to take a little bit of time. Shouldn't take too much time because I already did the updates before making this video. Because apparently Windows decided, I got updates to do, and they're very, very important. Of course they are. I actually did that update at 3.3 gigahertz. It was hilarious. That was actually before I realized the machine isn't going to reboot, though, and was not rebooting. And that's when I learned that 454 bus speed is really the absolute max. Maybe you'll have a little luck pushing it a little bit higher than that. But so far, and from what I've seen, 454 bus speed is really the highest you can do. Set 455 and the whole thing just goes to chaos. Fortunately, I'm still limited to my hard drives. I got Western Digital Greens in here. I do have a RAID 5 configuration going on, but it still is Western Digital Greens. All right, let's go ahead and waiting for the taskbar to load before it lets me do anything. Come on, hard drives, you can do it. Man, this is slow. And it's not the system. If you notice here, we barely got any CPU usage going on there, cuz. Now I should be able to click on the start button and open up CPU Z. Come on. There we go. We're getting there. Man, this hard drive. Telling you. All right, what tile is supposed to be up here? You don't even have an icon. You know what? I don't even care anymore. Windows 10 has an issue where sometimes tiles just don't load their icons. There is another video I'll make for how to fix that if tiles lose their icons. I'll do that tomorrow sometime. Yes, CPU-Z needs permission. Anyway, I wanted to do this video in real time just so you can actually see the process. The overclocking, how it's done, all that cool stuff. Because this is really cool stuff. Not gonna lie. All right, and here we go. 453.99. It's kind of sitting there, so let's go ahead and open up something. Let's open up Firefox. I'll move it down here so it's over here. You can see there it's going. It's got, because it only has two multipliers on this particular Xeon CPU, the Harpertown, the E5462. You only have 6 and 7. There's no other multipliers. Now, let's talk about multipliers in bus, though. Let's say, for example, here's something really cool. Now, remember, this machine is 10 years old, okay? So let's go to YouTube and say, I really want to push it. Now, my video card simply does not have VP9 decoding, which means all the decoding must be done on the CPU. Now, because we overclocked this by the bus and not by the multiplier, Windows doesn't quite understand that. So the Windows Task Manager will actually show the wrong CPU speeds, which you'll see here. We're simply not going down to 2.4 anymore. That's not possible. So this is actually a glitch. You can't go by this. Windows is dumb. But we're going to go over here to GPU and video decode. Perfect. That's what we want. And I'm going to do 4K test. Just to really, really rub this in that a 10-year-old computer is now able to basically pull this off. Let's see. 4K video. There we go. So right now it is running in 2160p. I'll even click it. Check this out. Check this out. No dropped frames on 4K video VP9. And you can see over here, the GPU is not decoding anything because in fact the CPUs are. And look at that. We're not even maxing them out now. This overclock's looking good. And I can go into full screen. No frames are dropped, still 4K. My monitor's only 2K, but oh well, it still is rendering the entire video at 3840 by 2160. What you can't hear is the fans are revving up a little bit because the CPUs are now getting hotter than they usually do. So with this playing, let's go ahead and check out those temps, see what we're actually hitting. Now for that, I need hardware info 64. Now, what's interesting is hardware info 64 also kind of gets the speeds wrong. Only CPU Z is going to show this because bus overclocks are a little bit different than multiplier overclocks, especially when the CPU is really not supposed to be overclockable. So let's get some CPU temps. Where are they? Here we go. Look at this, we're just chilling. Yeah, we are certainly chilling. Those are the different cores on the CPU. That's the first CPU, and here's the second CPU. As you can see, we're just chilling. Now, because we did upgrade the bus speed, that means the memory is now going faster. It's now the memory in here is double data rate, which means you get around 800 megahertz. And now it's around 900 and something, so let's go ahead and take a look at the memory temps. Yeah, we are kind of pushing that around 79 degrees Celsius. However, the maximum temps for the that are considered normal goes up to like 85 for this particular set. So you know what? We are doing fine so far. We are within reason. Everything else is certainly running very cool. No problems here. And you know, I just opened up all these programs and stuff and no drop frames. The only thing it still does struggle with is 4K, 60 frames per second. It just won't do it, but it will do 2K at 60 frames per second. However, it would do that on the stock speeds. Now, I want to talk about the overclocking method and why overclocking the bus speed is actually better anyway. So overclocking a multiplier is only overclocking the core of the CPU, okay? That only gives you a benefit. It only benefits your cores, but it does not benefit other things. Since we did a bus overclock, now we're not only just overclocking the CPU, but we're overclocking the memory. That's going to actually speed up a lot of things. Now, because of the clock generator does have separate clocks for like the PCI bus and things like that, you can overclock those as well, but I do not see the purpose. So, you know what? Don't do that. Leave those as is, because honestly, this is already pretty cool. Yeah, you know what? This is rocking it. So, for a 2008 Mac Pro, this is about all you're going to get. You're not going to get any more than this. If you have a different CPU, the 3.2 gigahertz model, you could probably push it even further. I really do not know. But because I'm now essentially getting almost the 3.2 gigahertz with the benefit of a faster frontside bus? This is the economical solution here, guys. This is where it's really at, because now we're actually overclocking more than just the CPU speed. We're overclocking parts of the machine. So after everything I did, out of 8,603 frames, none of them were dropped. Now, watch. I will go ahead and do the 60 frames per second test. It's simply not going to work, though. Let's go ahead and set this up. Okay, it's doing 2K at 60 frames a second. Now, that generally works just fine. No frames. So let's go ahead and switch that over to 4K. We are going to have some issues, though. And you can see now we're hitting a bottleneck. It's just not pushing out any frames, actually. So there is a little bit of a limit. But let's be honest. You can get these machines cheap now. You really can. So let's go to eBay. And realizing just what this machine is now capable of. So let's see. 2008 Mac Pro. Now, remember, this is Windows. As the title says, this is Windows. That's the 4-core model. Let's see. 2.8 times 2. Look at this. Starting bid, $26. All right. Now, my graphics card is not quite standard here. It's the Radeon 7800. It is patched with EFI, so that way you can boot. You can see boot on one of the DVI ports, but this is a mini display port monitor, so you got to install Windows on a DVI monitor, and once it's done and the drivers are installed, you can plug this in, and you're kind of good to go. As long as boot camp is set up as, or your Windows partition is set up as the boot drive, but you can actually set that using the Bootcamp Manager, which I would recommend installing anyway. An error has occurred. You may not have privileges to change the startup disk. That was a little weird. Is that a caveat of overclocking so the Bootcamp Manager does not work? Well, we'll return to that another time. Anyway, but that's a caveat. So let's go ahead and actually see now. Because we overclocked some things, let's actually go further and really push this machine into oblivion. So I'm going to go to gaming, global settings on my video card, and we're going to do something crazy. Let's do a 5% voltage overclock. 1050 at 1300. Let's hit apply. Awesome. So now my GPU has been overclocked to 1.05 gigahertz. The memory has been overclocked to 1.3 gigahertz. Because I actually already had it overclocked. I just never set the power control up to 5, which is really what you want to do. So let's go ahead and take a look at gaming. We're going to go ahead and open up. Where is it? I could have sworn I actually had Doom on this. Do I not anymore? Well, there's a solution to that. Let's open up Steam. I'll turn this away just in case I have anything that shows I don't like my gamer tag to show. Because I don't want people going nuts over me. Library games. Okay, I do have it. So let me actually change my sound card options to speakers. Yeah, we want speakers. All right, Doom. The Doom. Because, you know, Max can't game. Did they change this so that I can't play the game anymore? No, it's doing stuff. There it goes. Now, the only thing is I don't play at the full resolution of my monitor. I actually play at 720p, and there is a legit reason for this. It's the GPU. My graphics card just struggles a little bit here. And the skipping that you're seeing in the video intro is because of my hard drives. I have a RAID 5, so I mean, it should be a little bit faster, but let's just face it, 5400 RPM drives suck. Doom. Here we go. I don't want to buy now. I'll just load a campaign. New slot, start campaign demo. Now I'm gonna really suck at this because I'm gonna do it like with one hand. I don't have a tripod and I just realized that now. So this is really gonna be horrible. But I mean, we're not struggling to load things here. I mean, just a minor bottleneck in the system. Why aren't you focusing? Anyway, not, space to continue. Yeah, I'm trying to do this one-handed. That's just not working out very well. Oh, pressy. It's been a while since I played this. Yeah, remember, I mean, this is playing pretty well actually for this computer. And there is no real noticeable lag. I mean, maybe a little, but barely. I mean, this is working very well. Exit to desktop. And the cooling fan's only kind of marginally kicked in here. Like, it's really not revving up, really killing it or anything. So anyway, that's a video here showing the overclock of the 2008 Mac Pro running at close to 3.2 gigahertz. I'm not going to cry about a few megahertz off. I mean, we really are just a few megahertz off here. And it wouldn't have mattered anyway. So anyway, there you have it. Have a good one, everyone. If you have a 2008 Mac Pro and you want to overclock that 2.8 gigahertz to really something that would have been better than the 3.2 anyway, this is your way to go. Have a good one. Hi, Harley.